or eat it, you know, throughout the day, like my daughter, 3 times a week. That's her breakfast. Badam Pak is something, a bit of cross between fudge and a sheera. Eaten in all different forms, you can eat it hot or cold. I like to eat it in big cold chunks straight out of the fridge. You can just you know, use it as a dessert for any Indian meal or any Parsi meal that you plan to have. So let's talk about the ingredients for Badam Pak. Really simple ingredients that are available you know, in every locality, in every Indian household. This is roasted unsweetened mawa. The natural sugars present in this mawa are the ones that have caramelized a bit whilst during the cooking process, and that's why you have this brown hue on the mawa. And that's the kind of mawa you need to buy, because this adds a little bit of a caramel flavor to the Badam Pak, which kind of enhances or stretches the flavor a bit more. And then this is a home ground whole almond meal. I prefer to grind my almond meal myself because the store-bought ones are pre-ground, and what happens is the oils in the almonds, they kind of turn rancid with long storage times. The almonds lose flavor. So let's start with making our sugar syrup. So just your normal grain sugar and rose water. Now you could use normal water, but you know, traditionally good quality rose water gives you a nice inherent rose flavor. And if you do not like a very strong rose flavor in your Badam Pak, you could stop right there and not use the essence to elevate the rose flavoring later on. And you would just have a very background rose flavor to this Badam Pak. But if you like it the way we do in our household, we like a prominent rose flavor in the Badam Pak, then you would require to add the essence later on. I'm going to melt off all the sugar crystals before I amp up the heat to let the sugar start boiling. It smells like home. In fact, when Parsis have jashans, or our versions of puja, we use the same rose water you know, so it smells like we were doing a puja actually. There. So sugar crystals all disappeared, and now I can amp up the heat just to sort of bring it to a boil, and we'll just boil it for literally a couple of minutes. Make it slightly thickened. Once the sugar syrup is done, we will start by browning the almond meal in the pure ghee. There. Big boil just for a minute and we'll stop. So we just have to roast this almond meal in the pure ghee. So you will get a nice nutty flavor wafting from the pan, and then that's when you know that your almond meal is roasted. And it has to be done on a low flame, so this takes a bit of patience and a little bit of muscle work, but it's you know, well worth it in the end. You can see it's quite clumpy at the moment, but once we add the sugar syrup, you will see it all coming together as a homogeneous mixture. And I will soon now go ahead with adding the mawa. Now here is when the real muscle work begins, because now you will break up the mawa, get it mixed with the badam, and there you can smell now almost brown butter flavor that is coming out from the pan. So once the mawa is dissolved, we'll go very quickly with our rose water sugar syrup. And I know this looks like a bit of a mess right now, but you will see how it all comes together. You can see that it's slightly thickening now. So it will be fairly smooth if your sugar syrup is thin, you don't have to worry about lumps. If your sugar syrup is a little thicker, then it might form clumps, but it will be fairly smooth mostly, so you don't have to worry about clumps. All you have to do is watch out that the sugar, the hot, badam pak doesn't come onto your hands. Now we are at the sort of ribbon stage where, you know, it's leaving ribbons of almond fudge in the pan. As I stir, you get these lines in the halwa, in the badam pak. You see, whilst I'm stirring now, it's giving me a clean bottom at the edge, which now is telling me that the badam pak is done. So I'm going to now remove this. This is what 95% looks like. It gives me a clean bottom when I'm stirring. And your badam pak is really done. I'm going to add the nutmeg powder to it. And also to enhance it, we like it with a few drops of almond essence and a few drops of rose essence to enhance the rose water. Give it a quick stir. So for the plating of the badam pak, I'm using my mother's Parsi crockery. And then just going to sprinkle a few drops of rose water on the rose petals, on the badam pak, and garnish with almond slivers. These are blanched and roasted in ghee. Make some nice beurre noisette and use it to make this recipe. So we made badam pak today. This is a recipe that you can make in any home. It requires no special equipment, just a little bit of time and a little self-love. And you can always have it with your families and friends at any given point of time. It doesn't only have to be for Navroze, from my family to yours, wish you all a very happy Navroze. If you all do make this recipe in your homes, please do not forget to tag us at Theo Broma Patisserie India and me at Kainaz Messman. Thank you very much, and wish you all the best for the coming year.